A girl isn't pretty. the teacher of the specialty, even if we have to stay up all night. Say yes!
Yes. Chick, chick, chicken, scramble. 5, 6, 7, 8. Did you really play a 6-year-old Indian chief?
Manny!
What's the matter, kid?
Nothing. I just love still like sitting on the garbage can.
Yeah!
father got her.
Boy, am I tired. Not me. I could do the show all over again. On my hands and knees, maybe, but all over again. You want to see? Wait till Keeney sees this, then I'm really going to get a terrific raise.
Good luck.
I had a brief again to go out with a 60-year-old Indian chief, and I'm not looking for friendship.
I can't help it. That's what you found. I bet he knows Flossy Field. He could even know Mr. Wrigley from Spearmint. You know, Eddie, I've met a lot of guys like you. Fat, shorter, taller, thinner, but just like you, and they always turn out to be a friend.
I suppose hardly been a moon I've heard in ages.
Nicky Austin, did you see how he had polish on his nails?
Come on, kid, I'll take you home. We can. We could sit around and schmooze, huh?
Nicky Austin, Nicky Austin, I'll never see him again.
Fanny get into the dress.
Thank you. Thank you all for your cooperation. You all did wonderfully. I'm very proud of you.
Everybody, I'm Fanny's mama. I'm giving a party in my saloon for my Fanny. You're all invited. Oh, Mr. Ziegfeld, wasn't it lovely? Oh, especially my Fanny. Oh, you already know Mr. Ryan, and this is Florence.
Congratulations, Mr. Ziegfeld.
Thank you, Mr. Ryan. I appreciate it.
You know what I think, Mr. Ziegfeld, is to be a success on Broadway. You want to have a couple of peculiar ideas. A beautiful bride's gown on a girl in the family. Oh, excuse me, who would think of such a thing?
Only one person I know.
Mama, Eddie! Hi, Mrs. Ziegfeld. How do you think it went?
There's a few things I'd like to talk to you about.
Oh, we have to go. Miss Bryce is expecting that.
Yes, Miss Bryce, I am. You ruined my opening night. I believe you owe me an apology.
Look, I'm sorry I spoiled your opening night, but if I was right, you should have listened to me, so I think you owe me an apology, too. Okay, I will if you will. I'll even go first. I apologize, Mr. Ziegfeld, and I mean it.
In that case, Miss Bryce, I apologize. I thought you did wonderful.
Honest?
In fact, I'll prove it. There's a new song I'd like you to sing.
Something I feel really definite about is choosing my own songs.
Choosing your own what?
My own songs!
Congratulations to both of you.
Hey, it's you again.
You remember me.
You were my first ref with shirt and my first for $110 a week. Any competitors this time with better offers?
Ziegfeld has no competitors.
Good to see you, Nick. Hey, how are they running?
Ahead, just like you and this little girl.
You know, I discovered her before you did, Flo, and I had a hunch you two belonged together.
Oh, really? I got the same hunch, and it's aging me fast.
I knew it. I was sure of it. It was you who said something about me.
I'm afraid not. I wish I had.
Oh, but... I don't believe you.
Shall I call him back so you can ask him?
Oh, I'm sure you fixed it up that way between you two.
Well, there's a point at which honesty becomes ridiculous, so have it your way. I'm your benefactor, and as your benefactor, I have a right to be very proud of you.
I really did good, huh?
It didn't surprise me. After all, I was the one who wrote your card with the flowers. The white roses.
I didn't even have time to look. Dear Star, I told you so.
If you were a horse, I would have bet on you.
Do the horses you bet on always win?
No, but they're always the best on the track. You were on your way that first time. Now you're here. The question is, what do we do about it?
Something has to be done.
Oh, certainly. Success is something to enjoy, to flaunt. Otherwise, why work so hard to get it? Let's make grand entrances all over town. Watch people stare and whisper, "That's Ziegfeld's new song. Who's the lucky man? Don't you see? I wanna be seen with you on my arm, to wear you like a charm, your glitter decorating my heart. Now naturally, such proximity gives rumors to rise. Let them
I'd love to.
Really?
Of course.
Maybe you better think it over.
Why, have you changed your mind?
Oh, no, no. I mean, I know it is every night a glorified Zipa girl like me asks you out. This is just the neighborhood thing. It might waste the evening for
me. I'll be with you, won't I?
The moon.
Right.
strange. A sponge fits in any place.
I don't like him, Aaron, because I'm a rat. He's too good.
Gorgeous. You remind me of Baby's papa, my ex, also gorgeous. And wherever he is, he should only stay there.
Well, that's 57 cents to you. And 49 to you. And 32. And worth every penny.
Huh, a fine bunch of crooks I introduced to
you. Well, we're more practice is all. Oh, Fanny, I am so happy for your success. Only one thing could make me happier. To dance at your wedding. Sit down, children. Talk a little. Should I marry her now or wait till the party's over? Now.
Oh, but I love Mrs. Straycosh. And I'd cheat so she'd win that 57 cents. But anyway, I've been waiting all evening for a moment alone with you.
Congratulations, Fanny. I was busy with the baby before.
Thank you, Mrs. Nadler.
Alone with you and a block full of your intimate friends.
You get nagged and criticized around here, but not neglected. All I did tonight was open for the Follies. Now if I broke a fingernail, then you'd really see a fuss. Funny, I've imagined you practically every place in the world. Paris, London, the Delaware Water Gap, everywhere but Henry Street, and here you are.
You've imagined me?
Well, I've thought about you a little. Maybe it was the ruffled shirt. You're like a character in a book to me, and I haven't read any books, so that makes you a... I think it's your turn to see something.
Fanny, would you say you were a woman of wide experience?
About what?
Men.
Oh, sure, I've known a million guys. After all, I'm not 10 years old and I am in the theater. Just been too busy. What about you? Hundreds of girls, huh?
The count's in the mere dozens. And nothing serious. I like to feel free.
You can get lonesome being free.
You can get lonesome being that busy.
Who would think to look at us and be the same?
Travel single, oh, maybe we're lucky, but I don't know. And just let one kid fall down and seven mothers faint, I guess we'll.
18. I'll ring Paul. We got a little sharing before dinner.
Very good, sir.
Color's wonderful with your eyes.
Just my right eye. I hate what it does to the left. Tell me, are you planning on making advances?
I wasn't planning, but it does seem possible.
Before dinner or after dinner?
You look beautiful.
You don't have to make a leading lady dialogue. For me, I'm a comic.
On stage.
That's where I live. On stage.
Then you're missing too much.
You can't have everything.
Of course you can, you insist on it.
Hey, somebody laid a blue marble egg on the table.
I did. I got that in Europe ages ago. It's one of my favorite things, so I thought you might like it.
A blue marble egg? White roses? You sure went to a lot of trouble, even though I told you I might not even show up.
I hoped you would. Just as I hope you like very dry sherry.
I wouldn't know dry from wet. I never got past 3 feet, remember?
Shame you never made 4B. That's where they teach wine tasting. I remember you very well, Fanny. Inquisitive. Interested in everything. So full of life, you made everyone else look like a sleepwalker. All the things you're trying not to be right now.
I used to impress very easily. You were my first top hat. But I've met a lot of you since then. I'm a little older now, you know?
Funny, you seem so much younger. About 8, I'd say. A bad-tempered 8 determined on not enjoying anything. Why? What are you so angry about?
Who's angry? I'm sorry if I'm disappointing you in some way, but what did you expect? That you could come waltzing into my life after 10 months and say, I have a week before I go to Europe, and for me to fall into your arms?
Why don't you answer the question? Why are you so angry?
I'm not angry! And why don't you answer the question? You think I should be flattered because this time your train isn't leaving tomorrow morning. This time you have a week to kill. Well, I'm not a kid at Keys anymore. You're not slumming it anymore.
I never was, and you know it.
Don't holler at me.
I'm not hollering. You are.
That's different. I'm a natural hollerer. Anyways, I answered this silly question.
No, you didn't, my love, because you got angry the second you saw me. Before I even said a word, which surprised me because I lit up like a Christmas tree when I heard you were here.
Just the thought of great, big, wonderful me, huh?
Don't make fun of yourself, Fanny. You don't have to. And yes, it was at the thought of you. And I didn't think of it as a week to kill. I thought of it as a week to share.
Why didn't you come to my last 2 opening nights?
I was there.
Why didn't you go backstage?
Because you scare me half to death, Fanny. I meet a lot of people, and I forget them just as easy as I meet them. But I can't seem to forget you.
Maybe we should order now.
Certainly. If you're sure you want to stay.
Well, I might as well have dinner first.
Very sensible. Paul, I think we're ready now.
Caviar to game with Mr. Einstein?
No. Pate Strasbourg, I think. Then filet de bœuf. Sauce bordelaise, pomme de terre souffle, stem strawberries, endives, and a very light Bordeaux with the filet de bœuf.
Saint-Emilion, 1905.
Perfect.
Thank you, Mr. Artsy.
All right.
I would have ordered roast beef and potatoes.
I did. What's the matter?
Boy, if I can't tell when you're ordering roast beef and potatoes, how will I know when you're making
No. I'll be much more direct. You are a woman. I am a man.
members in Chicago. That's why we can't go home. Come on, kids, get on the train and settle down.
Do you know what that is?
Where's your husband? Of cardboard boxes that she monogrammed, yes.
She bought them yesterday.
Mrs. Fanny Bryce?
Oh, I'll take that.
Oh, Miss Bryce drinks champagne?
Yeah, well, times change. I'll see you on the train, honey. Come on, Porter.
Morning walks, monogrammed luggage, champagne? How long has Nick Arnstein been on that one?
Well, it was supposed to be for a week, but then he stayed through the month.
Yeah, he's not going to Chicago, though. First, he's going to New York, and then Europe. So there's nothing to worry about.
Oh, who's worrying?
I am. I was always nagging at her to go out and have fun.
So, in Baltimore, she went out and had fun.
Well, let's enjoy us and his alcohol. I call it Ryan's revenge.
Come on, girls! You don't want to be left in Baltimore, do you?
Baltimore.
Jane, help! Hey, Fanny, what did you do?
Buy a hat in Baltimore?
I wish I bought up the whole thing. It's the most beautiful city in the world.
Be a dear. Forget you lost your ruffled shirt on a race and come beautify Chicago with me.
Train ready on, track 8, boy!
I'm sorry, dear, that's mine. You'll have to improve Chicago all by yourself.
It doesn't bother you that Monte Carlo won't have me and Chicago will?
You know it bothers me, but for the 100th time, Monte Carlo has a deal waiting for me and Chicago hasn't.
Oh, there must be a law about you. You can't just walk in, change my whole life, and walk right out of it.
I'll walk right back into it with a fortune in each hand just as fast as I can.
Another definite date like last time, huh?
Not a bit like last time.
What's different?
I love you.
You mean that? I mean, you're not just trying to be polite? Nick, I'm a good friend of yours, and in a dumb way, I'm kind of smart. So I'm going to tell you what you want to do.
You want to marry me!
Hey!
You don't have to. I'm all yours anyways. But the kind of wife I'd be, you wouldn't believe. Check my records. No errors, no strikeouts, nothing. I'd be learning the part fresh. Your way. And besides that, I'm lucky. What's better for a gambler than a lucky wife?
We'll talk about it when I get back. All right? Loaded with money.
I want to talk about it now.
Fanny, listen. I do want to marry you. But not when I'm broke. I want to be the man of the house. So that nobody can say I married you because you're rich and famous. Now, you're a big and strong girl, awfully used to getting your own way. Are we going to do this my way or not at all?
Whatever you say, Mr. Armstrong.
You just remember that.
Let's go! We'll train the art board!
Why? Is it so impossible?
No, of course not, honey. Oh.
like he owns the world. And if you don't do that champion act, you're crazy.
Have you forgotten you're going on tour with this show?
I didn't sign a contract, Flo.
I count on you.
But the tour doesn't depend on me. You have five other top names in a week in Chicago to make adjustments.
That is completely selfish. Completely ungrateful and just completely...
Flo, will you simmer down before your ulcer starts flaring up again?
Oh, it's funny coming from you. You gave me the soul.
Oh my God, Flo, listen. I work hard. And I love the theater. It's wonderful. But you can't take an audience home with you, and I want a personal life too, and I'm gonna have it.
It's inconceivable, Fanny. It's unprofessional. And as for Nick Arnstein, if you want to know my opinion,
I don't! I'm going, and there's not a single thing you can do about it.
Fanny, if you do this, I'm through with you. And I mean it.